All right. As per this chapter, I was telling you language is a bit technical. So I'll be explaining the chapter in the easy language so that concept goes directly into your brain. Okay. Don't become rigid for any concept. It is a general chapter. Generalize things karenge hum. Don't become specific at one point. Right. Now, the term is netiquettes. What is netiquettes? When we talk with someone, we follow some etiquettes. We follow some rules. Okay. Beta, please, the back side shouldn't go at that side. Cover that side. No, they are Jyot Swarup and all. Aryansh, okay, two are there. Okay. We follow some rules. We follow some guidelines. Okay. When we communicate with each other. Right. When we talk with our elder, we follow some etiquettes. Okay. Similarly, when we are communicating on internet, when we are assessing internet, we are to follow certain rules. We are to follow some regulations. Like you are coming in the institution for attending the offline classes. You are bound by the school rules. Okay. You are bound by the school policies, by the school regulations, and you are to follow that. Right? Similarly, when we are on internet, we are to follow certain rules that how to behave online. One behave is with each other. One behave is online behave. How we are behaving when we are online. One term is citizen of India. In social, you might have heard this term so many times. Citizen of India. One is user of internet. Citizen means the person living in that particular country. Netizens means user using the internet. The person who is assessing the internet, the person who is using the internet is called netizens. Okay. So we as a netizens should follow some rules, okay, that governs our behavior online. Am I clear? Clear to all? Now, some of the guidelines which we are to follow to be a good netizens. How we can become a good netizen? Okay. We are to follow some guidelines, some factors, some points that will ensure that we can become a good netizen. First, be aware of what you post online. If point is not visible, I'm reading the point. Whatever we are posting on internet, we should be aware of that, that what we are posting. Unknowingly, we put our so many photographs on online. We share our photographs on Instagram, on any other social media. It may happen some person may copy our photo, may save our photo and make our fake profile. Unknowingly, we put status on WhatsApp. Unknowingly, we put status on Instagram. You never know who can save that data and who can play prank with you. Okay, so be careful about what statement, what facts you are putting online. Be careful of what you say. Like, kai bar elders kehte hai, beta, soch ke bolo. Hum kehte na kai bar aapko, soch ke bolo. Similarly, on internet, when you are writing something, when you are sending some audio message, suppose you are sending some audio message to your friend, you should think before what you are saying. Okay. Be mindful of privacy. Privacy means keeping the personal information confidential. Like our password, our OTPs, our debit card number, our credit card number, our IDs. Some things are very private. We should keep that information totally confidential. We should not disclose everything to everyone. like you are friends, you normally share your passwords with your best friends. You never know when your friend will use your password and can send any wrong matter to other third person. अब अगर A और B person दो friends हैं, B person ने A person ने अपना password B को दे दिया, B person ने उसकी ID को खोला और एक गलत email, wrong content third person को भेज दिया. Third person will assume what? That the message has come from A person. So who is responsible in the eyes of law? A person. So that is why it is every time recommended, do not share your passwords and confidential information with anyone. Aryansh and Pushkar, please be careful in the lecture. Listen to the lecture. Please stop your personal conversation. Avoid sharing fake news. If you are not sure about any fact and figures, don't share it. Right? If you are not confident about any particular information, you have some doubt, don't share the information till you are totally 100% clear that yes, information is correct. Now I can share. Don't spread any rumors. Don't spread any fake news online. Be truthful. Disclose the real fact. Don't give the fake statement, false statement. Credit the source when posting. There is one term called plagiarism. You might have studied in 9th class in cyber safety chapter. When we unknowingly copy the work of someone, copy the work. That is called plagiarism. Yes, Aditya Sharma, your thumb is too up, I know. We never read the work. Blindly, we copy the work. That is stealing someone's work. That is called plagiarism. Okay. I give one example to you. In your science book, you might have gone through some definitions given by some scientist or some renowned persons. At the bottom or at the top of definition, the name of the real creator of that is always mentioned. By Jim Cates, by John G. Kameny, जो भी author है, जो भी उसने, जिसने भी उसको invent किया, create किया, उसका नाम हमेशा वहां mentioned होगा. Credit the source means if you have copied the work from someone else, the work belongs to someone else, and you have copied, you mention the source that from where you have taken the work. Okay? Do not engage in cyber bullying. This is very important point. Cyberbullying is beta when we harm the reputation of some person online. We post something wrong, threatening message regarding some person. We try to harass that person online. We try to defame the person. Humne uski image ko spoil karne ki koshish ki. We try to defame him. This is cyberbullying, and it is 100% crime in the eyes of law. If you are fined culprit, a legal action will be imposed on you by the government. Okay? So never put any such message that affect the reputation of the person. Right? Share expert knowledge. If you have knowledge about any fact, any figure, do share it. Do explore that knowledge. Okay? Be careful when speaking about religion or society. We should respect all religions. We should respect every person who, regarding every society. Har ek religion ki, har ek person ki respect honi chahiye when you are online. Okay? Online students, up till here, am I clear? Aditya, Sahaj, Preet, Janvi. All right. Next comes is be a human. Use a signature, digital signature. Okay. Observe good grammar and spellings and appropriate emoticons. Emoticons, you know, the smileys that you send. Okay. The person is sad, depressed, and you are sending laughing smileys to him. Doesn't make the sense. Okay, be careful regarding the grammatical tenses, regarding the spellings, and what emoticons you are sending to the second person. Okay. Then e-commerce. These days, as we know that since 1.5 years, we are following the guidelines of the COVID-19. Okay. And many people, due to lockdown, they were going for online shopping. Like markets were closed. So people were going through the online shopping. Okay. Now, when we purchase something or we sell something, okay, the sale and purchase of goods, products, and services, when done online, that is called e-commerce, electronic commerce. यहां तक लेक्चर क्लियर है सारा? एक तो बेटा हम फिजिकली शॉप पे गए, हमने सामान खरीदा और हम घर आ गए. दिस इज नॉर्मल लाइफ शॉपिंग, फिजिकल शॉपिंग. वन, वी आर सिटिंग एट होम, वी आर नॉट गोइंग एनीवेयर, वी आर जस्ट एक्सेसिंग द इंटरनेट, वी आर जस्ट एक्सेसिंग द फेसबुक, द वेबसाइट, एंड वी आर परचेजिंग द प्रोडक्ट्स. वी लाइक द प्रोडक्ट, वी सेलेक्ट इट, we add in the book the cart, the shopping cart, we make the payment via debit card or credit card or cash on delivery as per our convenience. Okay, and we book the order. Okay, and we receive one mail from them that at so and so date the product will be delivered to you. This is e-commerce, what you call in simple terms, beta, online shopping. While doing e-commerce, certain ethics, certain protocols, certain rules are to be kept in mind. What are the ethics that we are to see while dealing in e-commerce? First is privacy. There are two parties. In the online shopping, two parties are involved, seller and buyer. Seller should know who is the buyer? Buyer should know who is the seller. Chant, be alert in the lecture. While the transaction is in process, both the parties should reveal true identity to each other. Seller should not disclose anything from buyer, should not hide something, and buyer should not hide something from seller. But the information which is personal should be kept personal. And if the buyer has disclosed his personal information, like buyer has given the debit card number to make the payment, seller must maintain the privacy, the secrecy of the buyer. Seller should not harm it. Right? Now, two questions are to be seen whenever we are dealing with the privacy. First question is how it intend to use the customer's data, or whether the customer can restrict the use of personal information. Seller has got the information about the buyer, how he should use that information, how the seller will use the customer's information, and how much information customer should provide. Sara kuch to customer reveal nahi kar dega na. Ek specific information jitni chahiye, jitni necessary, jitni relevant information hai, sirf utni hi deliver hogi. Right? Second is whether the customer is given. Oh, sorry. Whether the customer is given a choice to decide what information can or cannot be used for. How much information should he give? How much information is required? What is not required? Okay. When you do the online shopping, you might have done so many times. Jaise Zomato hi hai, aap kuch mangate ho Zomato se. Whatever is in that digital form, only that thing you enter. You do not provide anything extra from your side. Okay? safeguard user privacy. This is very important concept in the case of privacy. How to safeguard, how to protect the privacy of the user. To ensure that user privacy is not compromised, certain factors are to be taken care of. First, the seller must clearly state how the user data will be used. I am seller, she is the buyer. She has sent information to me. I should keep total check that how much data I have to use, how much relevant portion of data I have to use. The seller or merchant must ensure that user has gone through terms and conditions. There are some paid sites, paid apps, just a Disney Plus Hotstar, Netflix, Amazon Prime. They are paid. You may take monthly subscription, you may take yearly as per your convenience. Before purchasing that, you might have seen that whenever we download any app, terms and condition page always open first. और नीचे I agree का बटन होता है या I accept terms and conditions. उसके बाद कई बार ये भी आता है this website, this app wants to access your contacts, allow, deny while using this app. Okay, read those terms and conditions. Sometimes you might have seen in-app purchases. When you play some game on, download some game from Play Store, like Criminal Investigation. जब भी आप ये game purchase, game ये download करेंगे, you start playing the game, and while investigation is going on, तो वहाँ पे जैसे वो कहते हैं कि एक process है, कोई product मिला, okay, they find some product, and which was the key proof, key evidence for this case. Okay, तो उसकी processing होती है. वहां पे क्या आता है? Whether purchase, whether wait for 6 hours. ऐसा होता है game में. तो either you purchase, and if you purchase, immediately the proof will get processed. Either you wait for 6 hours. Okay, अभी recently a game आई थी Train Simulation 21. That train city was to be created, and from the initial route they have that barren land and all that, and उसमें काफी ऐसी चीजें थी कि उसमें आपको या तो wait करो time की इतने time बाद, और जब time मान लो आप time की wait कर रहे हो, ठीक है, you are waiting for the time that after 2 hours this process will get complete. Okay, so when the process will get complete, you will receive notification from the game's app that so and so process has been finished, access it, claim it, or whether you can go with online purchase. So terms and conditions must be read before you download that app into your smartphone or computer or whatsoever. The seller must assure the user about safety of the data. मैंने पहले ही बता दिया आपको ये point. Safety बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है. If buyer is not secure online, if security is not provided, the buyer will never go for shopping. These days you might have seen one new feature has come. When you open the WhatsApp from your smartphone to computer, the password is asked. पहले नहीं होता था. जैसे मैं अपने टैबलेट से अपना व्हाट्सएप कंप्यूटर पे अगर मैं खोलना चाहूं तो आई हैव टू एंटर माय पासवर्ड फर्स्ट, देन आई विल बी एबल टू एक्सेस माय व्हाट्सएप ऑन कंप्यूटर. व्हेन यू डू सम ट्रांजैक्शन, ओटीपी कम्स ऑन द रजिस्टर्ड मोबाइल नंबर. ओके, द यूजर एंड बायर मस्ट गो थ्रू ऑल टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस रिगार्डिंग एनी सेंसिटिव इंफॉर्मेशन. देयर माइट बी सम क्लॉज इन द टर्म्स एंड कंडीशन which is very important, which is very sensitive. So we should not overlook the terms and conditions. Unknowingly, we click on I agree. We never read the conditions. And later on, we have to repent for something. Okay? Aditya, Sehajpreet, Janvi, am I clear with the lecture? All right. Next concept, next ethic is fraud. Fraud. When it happens online, it is called online fraud. And this was the case study in the previous year board examination, the pre-board. This was the case study topic, fraud. When it happens online, we say it is online fraud. Okay. Now, in what forms it occur? Kis kis form mein fraud hota hai? First, non-delivery of goods. You make the payment. Transaction was successful. Payment was done via debit or credit card, but you didn't receive the goods. That is the case of fraud. One kind of fraud. Second, non-existing companies. The company was fake, but it was created in such a way, the website was created in such a way, it looks genuine, but it was not genuine. Stealing information. Your credit card information was misused. It was hacked by the hacker. Your ID was hacked by the hacker. Your password was cracked. Fraudulent payments. Aapki payment ka misuse ho gaya. So these are the four forms in which fraud occurs. Okay. Now see the red note here. The first two types of fraud can be countered by setting up official bodies. The first two means non-delivery of goods, non-existing companies. Ye do fraud to hum compensate karwa sakte. We can file a complaint with some official body and the necessary action can take place. Okay. Comes to the third and the fourth fraud. Stealing information and fraudulent payments. The most dangerous type of fraud. Stealing information, fraudulent payments. Okay. Now, first is credit card fraud. Your credit card or debit card information is misused. It was hacked by the hacker. Okay. Then identity theft fraud. What is identity theft? In simple terms, if you want to define what is identity theft, raise your hand only. Don't speak just as no. Yes, Pushi. Stealing someone's personal information, personal details, the identity of a person, stealing the identity of a person. Okay, clear? And then using that information for some malicious activity. Malicious means some wrong activity that can harm the image of a person. Right? How to stop the frauds? In order to stop the frauds, certain measures are to be taken. This was also a part of MCQ question. Tick mark the correct measure to stop the online fraud. Okay? When you get the case study, it may happen the questions which are given here, the answer for them may not be in the case study. It will be in connection to the topic. So you must be aware about that topic in detail. A monitoring official body that ensures the sanctity of the e-commerce means the real status, what transaction was, when it happened between two bodies, the two parties in which transaction took place. Strong security mechanism. You might have seen that HTTPS and HTTP. S means secure website, secure connection between the source and the destination, between sender and buyer. Secure payment methods. Okay, like you are doing some payment, you properly receive the OTP at your mobile. That is a security check. And OTP will always come on the registered number only. Suppose OTP doesn't come and direct payment got cut. That can be the case of fraud. Official guidelines and safeguards on selling the user data to third party. There should be proper check which is kept online that what information is revealed out. Koi aisi information na ho jo user ke liye sensitive ho aur wo hum third party ko bhej rahe, hacker ko bhej rahe. Right? Okay, I stop the lecture here. We'll continue in the next class.